Apex predators are defined as organisms with no natural predators that dominate the trophic pyramid. Here in North America, human activities have reduced populations of many of these organisms, the effects of which are still largely unknown. One interesting area of research within this topic is the impact of apex predator presence or absence on the abundance of lower-tier mesopredators, such as coyotes, raccoons, or opossums. To investigate any possible correlations between these two variables, my research team used data from over 1,500 camera traps deployed at well over 100 locations throughout North America. We first organized every site into a different category depending on the number of apex predator species present, the categories being 0, 1, or 2+. We then calculated the average mesopredator abundance across each of these gradients. Here's what our analysis revealed. Most importantly, an ANOVA t-test revealed that there is a strongly positive correlation between apex predator presence and mesopredator abundance. Additionally, the effect of apex predator presence or absence seems to have different impacts on different species. As you can see in this color-coded bar graph, northern raccoon abundance decreases exponentially with increased apex predator presence, while species such as coyotes and skunks are actually slightly benefited. While we are still unsure of the exact mechanism that's responsible for this anomaly, one possibility is that unequal predation pressure is exerted on different species of mesopredator. It's also very likely that there are confounding variables which we did not test for that could be impacting our data. One confounding variable that might be responsible for this effect are differences in human population densities at each of our study sites. Perhaps raccoons are doing so much better at sites with fewer apex predators, not because there are less apex predators, but because there are more humans. To investigate this trend, we will need further research that controls for human population densities across the different gradients. From an ecological perspective, there are many possible consequences to the correlation that we observe between apex and mesopredators. A reduction in the populations of nest predators, such as raccoons, could have great conservation benefit to ground nesting birds and reptiles, whose populations may be limited by high levels of nest predation. Another potential ecological consequence of this correlation is reduced zoonotic disease transmission from mesopredators, such as raccoons, to dogs and cats. No matter what further analysis reveals, we can say with confidence that there is a significant correlation between apex predator presence and mesopredator abundance. This correlation alone is enough to cause ecosystem-level changes in species composition that we are just beginning to understand.